Not only is it nourishing and sustaining, but it's one of life's real joys. And so sometimes when we sit down to fast, the prospect of eating vegetables for 40 days, phew, it's a bit of a, yeah, not something that we really relish. But actually, it's something more than just eating vegetables. There's something much more profound about fasting. It got me thinking about communion. There's an interesting counterpoint between communion and fasting. It's like a feasting and fasting. Now, communion is taken to remember Christ's sacrifice, and that is our atonement. And now the Day of Atonement in the Old Testament is about denying yourself, and Christ's sacrifice was about denying ourselves. And he says to us, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. So when we fast, it's a physical demonstration of denying ourselves, about taking up our crosses. But more than that, it's about following him. So the practice of fasting is about delving into who he is and following him. It's about connecting with Jesus. It's about connecting with the sustainer and giver of life and declaring his kingdom until he comes. So I trust in this season of fasting is a joy to you, that you may connect with the sustainer of life and find joy in fasting